1833. The town is Canterbury, in Windham County, Connecticut.
In the first two desks over there. Marcia should be free in a moment.
Marcia? No, Miss Crandall. I had something to ask of you.
Yes?
Miss Crandall, my father, as you know, has prospered. And in recent time, I have entertained some thought and have considered with my family the prospect of... I want to go to school here.
Me, Sarah. I was startled, simply. I know that you're more gifted than most, but... Well, the term's already begun.
But I know sums, Miss Crandall. I write a reasonable hand. I went to district school with the girls you have here now.
Sarah, this is a private school. I charge tuition.
My father can pay. I have an ambition to teach, Miss Crandall. God gave me some... quickness of mind. My father's waiting for me outside. If you'd rather speak with him...
No. Sarah, I esteem your father as much as any man, and yourself. But the obvious fact... Sarah, I teach only refinements here. Deportment, the French language, needlework. Things you'd have no practical use of. I couldn't in all good conscience... In all good conscience, how could I refuse you? Inform your father the tuition is $25 per quarter.
News of you here in Canterbury. No rest till I had come to refresh my soul in your courage.
Needed no special courage, friend May. Sarah Harris is a friend of
mine. Oh, but we may lift up those who are lying in chains and ignorance.
Sarah Harris is not lying in chains. Her family are free persons. They're as well esteemed and well circumstanced as...
But she is a negress, and there will be trouble.
No.
No, there hasn't been the slightest trouble.
It lies in human nature. This is a private school. A man sends his daughter here to be cultivated and to show off his own wealth, eh? Now then, what happens when a man discovers that the best schooling he can afford his daughter is open to a common negress? I put it in their terms, of course. Or what happens with the other class of men, the poor farmer, say, who has always envied the rich Negro Harris, but always consoled himself that after all, a Negro is at least barred from certain... Do you not see, Miss Crandall? You have taken away their comfort.
But there hasn't been the slightest trouble.
But there will be. I have experience of these things. And when it comes, Miss Crandall, why do we not use it?
I don't follow you.
Miss Crandall, I have a proposition to put before you. In all of our cities, New York, Boston, Hartford, there are free, prosperous Negro children who hunger and thirst after knowledge as devoutly as any white. I could advertise for them here, in our newspaper. I could collect pupils for you, Miss Crandall.
I have no need.
But if you lose your white pupils, you could fill up your school again, full and overflowing.
I won't lose my pupils.
Miss Crandall, out there is a trembling in the air. Do you not sense it? The voice of a race in slavery crying out. They start to rise up. They reach out for freedom and knowledge. and the oppressors are gathering in hatred and fear to keep them down. Do you not feel it? A holy violence soon coming when God strikes off their chains.
Reverend May, my God is not violent.
No. No. No, you are a Quaker. But God has given you to strike a blow or to bear a martyrdom.
I don't want to be a martyr. I want to teach, that's all.
We are an army gathering, an army of the weak and the scorned. God arms us with righteousness and heads us toward the reeking, bloody lions of war.
Reverend, you speak with some appetite.
Huh?
Whatever, that's not our part. Miss Crandall's a school teacher, simply, and if I can bring her to it, she may make a passable wife. You want her for a soldier? I need her as a companion. I was ordained recently. I've been offered a pulpit in Illinois.
Reverend, I felicitate your...
So why puff all this up into some great issue? She's allowed Sarah Harris to school. There have been... Who's that? Against the door. Where are you? It's quiet.
Yes, it's a quiet town.
No special damage. It's only cracked the door.
And the town were gathered to stone the adulteress. And Christ said, let him who is without sin cast the first stone. Someone has found himself without sin. Or more sin than he can bear.
It's a bit early to talk about adultery. I'm not yet married.
Well, I mustn't hinder you. Besides, I have some distance to travel. Miss Crandall, think well of what I have said to you, and if you have needed me.
I thank you.
I wonder, have they snarled my harness?
Me feel sinful. No sooner does a minister quit the house than we fall to kissing.
But I am a minister. It's all proper.
Thee is no minister. Thee is a loutish, cloutish, lustful blacksmith.
And thee is no proper schoolmarm.
He's a strange, queer man, the Reverend May, isn't he?
Aye. A virtuous man?
Trouble, turmoil, stirrings outside. I don't believe him. There was that rock.
Well, now, girl, will you marry me next week or not?
Next week?
I'm pushed to give an answer. Whether I'll take that Illinois post. I have to go to New Haven to discuss it, and I thought to take you along.
He has impatient thoughts.
I think of my own pastorate, my own wife, children. How they are got, we must find out.
Oh, Cal.
So I make haste not to lose thee to the Reverend May and his sweet songs of struggle. He has that in thee, that energy I wanted myself. Girl, on the Sabbath next, there is nothing to put it off.
Perhaps if I conceive it as a duty.
As a duty?
St. Paul said it's better to marry than to burn. Send for the surgeon.
Faith d'envoy. Faith d'envoyer. Le chirurgien. I am dying.
Je meurs.
Je meurs. French is a musical, delicate language, Debbie. See, now I'm dying. Cheer up. Have you been bled, Sarah?
Prenez courage. Avec vous, j'étais saigné.
C'est bon. It is in three porringers upon the window.
Miss Crandall, a word, please.
Excuse me, Demi.
Ouvre la porte, parce que...
Prudence, we had a meeting of town yesterday. We take great pride in you, Prudence, and this school. We invited you here, found you this house. We loaned you the money to pay for it, supported you for your first year.
Neighbor, I was teaching a class.
Yes. Well, then. Yesterday, we discussed the issue of Sarah Harris.
Why does everybody cry her up to be an issue? She is a young woman, not an issue.
Prudence, God made us different in character and mentality. And God marked that difference with color for men to understand and to respect.
Sarah Harris wants to go among the slaves and teach.
You give the slave a little knowledge. Rouse up his poor brain to fret and to wonder. Start him to question the natural order of things and what lies ahead. Discontent and dissension? Rebellion? Blood? Can you doubt it? Can you not feel it stirring?
You speak like the Reverend May.
May? The abolitionist? Does he have some hand in this? Prudence, to have dealings with a man like May, a schemer, an abolitionist, well, if he seduced you in some way...
I am not seduced. I keep a school. I am beholden to no one. And if I choose...
Sarah? Forgive me, girl. Sarah.
Friend Harris.
Miss Prudence, I have to spare you some trouble.
There won't be any trouble.
As parents coming to take their daughters out.
Wait. We told them there'd be no haste. We told them we'd settle things.
Settle things? Friend Harris, I'm sorry. I hadn't thought that.
Nor had I. I own the mistake. Sarah, come along if you will, Sarah. We have done Miss Crandall some damage.
Deborah, come along, girl.
Oh, Father, there's no need.
Miss Kenter, I'm asked to fetch you along, too.
See here, Bailey.
Oh, there's no need.
Elspeth, you come home with me.
Wait.
Deborah, come along right
now. No, now, wait. Ben, it's all right.
Eh? Is the nigger gone?
No. No, and she will not be.
Please to calm yourself.
Calm I am as a hatchet. Now get yourselves out of here.
It's anger only.
You put it here. Don't broadcast anger all over town and then come here polite to me. God help me, but I hate hypocrites. Take your daughters out. I'll find others. I'll teach. But I will teach. I will teach.
Not the fittest name for her, Prudence.
Prudence Filio. She's married now.
Aye. And I had hoped it would gentle her down. Calvin's a sensible man. Advertising for pupil out of state. When are the new pupils coming?
This morning.
Rich little city girls. Mulattoes. City niggers. Not our kind.
Who are our kind?
Girl. We're an old family in this town. I grew up living here. And if a neighbor wants to borrow a pail from me, or I want to borrow a whetstone from him,
We think nothing of it. They call me by name. I call them. And if they're all black, and I'm all white, we don't think to wonder. We think nothing of it. Until now.
They tried to keep me from school.
Oh, they did a hurtful thing. What waste of time. Give them patience. She's not waited, this little Quaker lady. She's as much patience and prudence as a wild Indian.
To their rooms.
Yeah. This way, girl.
Miss Crandall?
Oh.
Yes?
I'm Anna Eliza Hammond.
Be welcome, Miss Hammond. Do you have luggage?
Yes, with the others. A trunk.
I'll show you to your room.
Miss Crandall. I can't bring no more of them.
Purdy.
Andrew Judson's gone to legislature for a law against you. They say he's got it already.
I've had no news of it.
Anyhow, I can't haul for you no more. People tell me not.
Friend Purdy, you're not afraid of people, are you?
Aye. And so you'd do well to be.
Miss Crandall. Forgive me, Mrs. Filio. You've already met Mr. Charles Burley.
Yes, won't you come in?
And how are these last few days?
The days go well enough. The nights are... Last night they brought dead animals. A cat, a dog with no head, mutilated chickens, and heaped them up in front of the door.
Yeah.
Sir?
Mr. Burley is a journalist. He can make all of these atrocities known everywhere. New York, Philadelphia, Boston.
Have they done else?
He set fire to the back house.
May I see?
Reverend May, my husband has advised me that if there's less outcry in the newspapers, if we adopt a more conciliatory spirit...
Conciliation? We are doing God's work, Miss Crandall.
Mrs. Filio...
We need the outcry. We need the battle. Where is your husband?
He's gone to Wyndham to get food. They won't sell to us in town anymore.
We need fortitude. Miss Crandall... Here is pain. Let us embrace it. Until every burden is as joyful to us as the caress of the hand of God.
My husband, I think of late, feels rather heavily caressed.
Thank you, Sarah. I'll take these. Store them down in the cellar.
Is this for the kitchen?
Aye.
Miss. Could you call Miss Crandall's porter? My trunk.
Excuse me.
Sir.
What?
Are you Miss Crandall's porter?
No, miss.
How does she employ you?
Well, she sometimes has me kiss her and hug her.
Oh, Cal. And... Miss Hammond, have you met my husband?
Oh, Mr. Crandall.
Filio, Reverend Filio. I'm Mrs. Filio properly. Calvin, would you fetch...
Yes, yes, yes. Forgive me. Yes, in a moment. I want some water.
Reverend, I wish to talk with you privately. Your wife has said that you have spoken to her of moderation. Believe me, Reverend, this is not a time that we should.
Foul! They've polluted the well. Now I can fetch and carry water, too.
What is it?
It's foul. They've polluted the well.
Oh,
Reverend, believe me, we must accept the trials that are put upon us.
Why do you always speak with such an appetite?
Reverend,
now, what are you writing? God's I don't want
word,
anything
please,
in the paper.
Let go of me. This is God's work that we are doing, Reverend.
I am a minister, my... Prudence!
Girl, can you speak?
Does he find me dead?
Not nearly.
What's happened?
Someone threw this from across the hedge. Here, I'll bathe her head.
From the well?
No help here in the house. I'll get a doctor.
Come, Mrs. Jaleel. Come. You're all right. Come. Come. All right.
My wife's been struck on the head. Not much hurt, I think.
Shirley, wait.
She's not much hurt, you say?
I think not. But if you'll come...
I'll give you a salve. I won't go. Look, we have no dealings with you. You know that. No one in town. I'm doing much to give you a salve. Forgive me, but I have a fear that if this...
I'll come give you something to fear. Reverend. Give me the salve.
Calvin, what is it?
I don't know.
No, I'm well enough.
We're back from legislature, miss. We have a law for you.
Is that the celebration?
Here. I'll read it to you. Whereas attempts have been made to instruct colored persons belonging to other states, which would tend to... Miss, you're hurt.
Go on reading.
No. How'd it come?
Read on, sir. Read on.
No.
It'll be all right. I have some salve from the doctor, City. Let me see.
Sir, please, if I may. Be it enacted by the Senate and the House of Connecticut that no person shall establish any school or institution of colored persons who are not inhabitants of this state.
Say enough, sir.
Don't hold up in court. Unconstitutional. Violates the full faith, credit clause.
It'll hold up in Canterbury.
No, sir, nowhere. Good lawyer can take that.
Please!
Girl. A disappointment?
But this is only the start of things. Let your wife teach her to defy this wicked law. Bring her to court. People like to read of trials and injustice and injuries.
Would it suit you best, sir, my wife dead?
Woman, I have nothing to offer you but pain, devotion, the right. But you have suffered already. If you wish to draw back now, I have no blame to say. Your husband opposes, and you have a duty to him. I cannot intervene. Let me know tomorrow how you say. Good day, Reverend.
Girl, you gave yourself to that man. He's had the use of you. That's enough, eh?
I never gave myself to him.
To his great issue, then. The cause, abolition.
I only wanted to teach.
What's left of that? I'm sorry. You're hurt. I shouldn't rail at you. And I should have kept a better temper in my part. Carrying supplies and all.
Was a noble carrier.
What say ye then? I carry thee someplace better.
Oh, husband, I love thee.
Nay, it's not the question. I mean, will you give this thing over?
Calvin, if they must make an issue of me.
Girl, do you like to suffer?
I have a selfishness to teach, and I have a right.
Woman, you are my wife.
It was a part of me before I was a part of you. And God forgive me, Calvin, I didn't know how great a part.
Reason for this pageant. She's brought here at night. She's locked up.
She's quite content to be locked up.
It's your scheme. You could post a bond for her if you pretend to be her friends.
Mr. Judson, you put her here. The whole country knows that.
You're a propagandist.
And you give us fine news to tell. Mr. Judson, you are a silver fish that has been caught in the light.
Reverend May, I have listened to your... Calvin... I'm not a violent man.
I think you are, Mr. Judson. You turn this town on.
No. No, I'm only its voice.
Judson, I was a blacksmith before a minister. If this town brings more harm to my wife, I'll come visit its voice.
Are you falling violent, Calvin? The thing's at law now. If this town has any hope in the law...
What if your law is overturned?
Calvin, I've spoken to people... The things are smoother now, you know that. But they were worried. Right next door to Prudence, they were worried that if they should sell their house, they might find the labor and the earnings that they put into it flown away. The value lowered. They themselves lowered.
He's discomforted. Tomorrow he'll be more. I told him that your wife would be more comfortable in the back cell, and the last person to use that cell was a condemned murderer. Tomorrow, the newspapers will have it all.
There's a pallet to lie on, table, chair, other small necessaries.
Describe it. It's just like any other jail cell. Have you never seen one?
Calvin, let me touch you.
I could think of ways it's easier done.
Can't you feel the joy of it?
The Reverend May feels joy. Would you rather talk to him?
Poor Calvin. He's not quiet of soul.
Prudence, do you have everything you need in there?
It only lacks a husband.
Listen, girl. I know your jailer, Tom Ahern. He could sneak you out, and I could get you back here before morning. Would not?
Calvin, that's not proper.
We've girded our loins. We must bear our trials.
Aye. You've girded yours well enough.
Calvin, would you tell, Mr. Burley that I need a glass to look to my appearance?
Ye are an adulteress.
Husband.
Aye. You've made me a sop and an ass. And a cuckold. I'm the first man ever cuckolded by the entire abolitionist movement.
To the charge as follows. That at Canterbury in the county of Windham in the year 1833...
The first trial of Prudence Crandall in August 1883 ended with a split jury. The second trial came in October. She was found guilty.
And is fined the sum of $100 and released to further jeopardy, save of keeping the law.
Thank you.
What's the point to it? There she goes out free.
She's been fined. She's been found guilty.
Aye. And there she goes back to her school. And it's still there, and the nigger girls. And she goes on teaching of them.
Now, the case isn't closed yet. She's made an appeal to the Court of Errors. I'll argue the case there. Successfully, I surmise.
Andrew, you go on having successes and the school's still there. You could go to this next court and they could turn everything back?
They could.
We've put trust in you, Judson.
Well, then keep it. The law's not simple-minded. This is a lawful town, isn't it?
Has she obeyed the law?
Tom, we're all neighbors to each other, aren't we?
Got my husband back.
But you're still in peril of the law and what people do and say.
But what I must do, that's decided. That gives me great peace, great content.
Whatever.
Yes.
Girl, we must talk now before you go in. I have to go to New Haven. I can't put it off longer. Now, I've made arrangements with Mr. Harris to bring your provisions and some neighbors to keep an eye on the house. And as you say, it's been quiet enough.
To New Haven to talk to the church board?
Aye, to find if the Illinois pulpit's still open to me. And if so, to tell them I accept.
Yes.
And if so, I must then travel out to there. So we must decide how it is between you and me. If you'll come with me, or if I'll go out there first and you plan to join me out there later, after a time. I can't command you. That's not our fashion.
Yes.
But I have to go my way. Even if we are quite a long time separate. Now, if you choose to come with me now, this first little trip, it's the weekend.
Calvin, I might. I could just step in. I won't take many things. I'll just step in for a moment.
Pensive and melancholy.
Vous me paroisez vivant et melancholique.
I do confess I am in love.
Je vous avoue que je suis amoureuse.
The natural heat of the blood is the cause of love.
La chaleur naturelle de cœur, c'est la cause d'amour.
It proceeds from the liver.
Eh bien, originairement du foyer.
Originairement.
Originairement.
The hearts of men are deceitful and full of guile.
Le cœur des hommes sont.
Dear Prudence, I am delayed here beyond my expectation. I am told your case will come before the Court of Errors on Tuesday after next. I hope I shall be with you then. Your affectionate husband, Calvin Filio.
If you receive this Illinois pulpit, would your wife accompany you?
I cannot say, Reverend. My wife is engaged in teaching and at law.
We have interviewed several younger men for this pulpit. All are married.
It's only fair, Reverend.
Reverend, a preacher's wife should take care of his house, tend the sick of the parish, and attend the moral instructions.
I think my wife would know her duty, Reverend.
If she accompany you.
Will she accompany you?
If the case at court go against her, as I have said, Reverend, it's likely. If it go in her favor, I'm not sure of the answer.
Reverend, the case was called early. It was deliberated this noon. It was not decided either for or against your wife. It was only set aside.
Come down, girls, come down. They're coming. Thank you. Girls, we have much to rejoice. We've been taken from the jeopardy of the law, which I've much abused. Oh, it seems that you may be allowed to remain here, and I may be allowed to remain here with you. We may keep school together and celebrate the mercy of God and the law. Now, girls, we've won this at great cost to ourselves, and I feel that if we don't continue...
Fair night's work, eh?
Where are the children?
They're in the back rooms. That minister fellow with them, the Reverend May, wringing his hands like a sailor's monkey.
Who did all this?
We'll never know.
Where she is?
Who's there? Get yourself gone. I'm armed.
Reverend May. Where's Prudence?
I don't know. She's about somewhere. She's out of her mind, I think, from fear.
I had no hand in this.
Did you not?
Get going! Get away from here!
Who do you shove?
Eh?
Who do you shove? He'd do well not to anger me. Don't anger me!
Mr. Harris, don't set them on again.
Eh?
There are many of them. Mr. Harris, the meek shall inherit the earth.
Eh? Well, then I have some payments due. Sarah! Sarah! Fetch them out. I have a wagon. I'll get the children to Wyndham. They can take coach from there. Judson, get aside. They are fighters of ye. Judson, behold thy victory.
Behold yours.
Mr. Harris, I did nothing of this.
It was in a cause, and the cause is right.
Keep ye both away from me. Ye are white, I see. Ye gave me the gift to see it.
It will be no matter someday.
Someday after me. It's matter to me. Ye are like to each other enough for me.
No.
Aye. Ye look white together. I'll hate ye both together. It simplifies me.
Mister.
I'll stand away.
Where is my wife? Is she hurt?
May! Where's my wife?
I don't know. She's hid inside somewhere. But she's not been hurt.
Prudence? Anna. Where is she?
Down there. I don't know to what purpose.
Is she hurt?
No. I started down to her. She saw my black face and she screamed.
Oh, no, no, Anna.
Prudence?
Taking the children.
You'll start them off to their own homes. And May and I'll see to the rest of things.
I had no thought of this. I shouldn't have left thee. I could say you shouldn't have tried to do the right. You have a hard little head, girl.
I might tame ye to an obedient wife. Find the spare in that. You're a reckless, stubborn, violent woman. And so you'll always be.
As soon as you pass this, you'll be off to other battles. And it's my weakness to love you so. So you've lost a school, eh? Now listen, girl. A school is where a teacher is. Do me a kindness. Come out to Illinois with me. Do that much, and if you want a school, I'll build you one. And you can teach whoever you want. And those ye teach will teach others, will they not? A sort of holding hands through time. So many of you holding hands. There's no strength like a teacher's. Will you come with your husband?
Strong woman, and I am a fearful weak man, but I can carry thee.
Prudence Crandall Filio went with her husband to Illinois, where she continued to teach Negro children. She was finally vindicated in 1886 when the citizens of Canterbury said in a petition, "Mindful of the dark blot that rests upon our fair name, we desire a pension for Prudence Crandall and requests that her conviction be erased from the record." This was done at a time that marked the 52nd anniversary of the demolishing of her school.
These stories of past courage can teach, they can offer hope, and they can provide inspiration. But they cannot supply courage itself. For this, each man must look into his own soul.